going to use an interactive simulation in this screencast to try and get a little better physical feeling for what we mean by fugacities by looking at fugacities in a can of soda. So the idea is we're going to compare water fugacities and carbon dioxide fugacities and compare them to each other and also compare them to concentrations in the liquid phase and the vapor phase. One thing to keep in mind when we're talking about equilibrium between a liquid and the vapor, the criteria for equilibrium is that the fugacity for a given component is the same in each phase. So if we look at a snapshot of this simulation at 0 degrees C, what we've listed is the fugacity of carbon dioxide, 3.11 bar, and so that's essentially the partial pressure of CO2 in the gas phase. And we've also looked here at the fugacity of water, 0.00606. That's also the saturation pressure of water at this temperature. And so the fugacities differ dramatically in the gas phase, and the carbon dioxide fugacity is almost 3 orders of magnitude higher than the water fugacity. But if we look at concentrations, so we look at liquid phase concentrations, and we see that the water concentration in the liquid phase is a couple of orders of magnitude higher than the CO2 concentration in the liquid phase. In contrast, if we look at the vapor phase, now the concentration of CO2 in the vapor phase is almost 3 orders of magnitude higher than water. Indeed, these are directly proportional to fugacities. And so when we look at a given phase, we can't immediately identify which component has a higher fugacity just because it has a higher concentration. And remember, our criteria for equilibrium is that fugacity in the liquid and the vapor phase is the same for a given component. So let's look at this simulation briefly to give you an idea. What we're able to do in this simulation is change the temperature and see how this affects the fugacities and the concentrations. So here's the simulation. These are the values we were just looking at. So let's raise the temperature. Of course, the pressure goes up. So pressure of CO2 goes up because we're looking at a closed container. And raise the temperature, we're going to raise the pressure. We're actually also raising the saturation pressure much more significantly. So now if we look at the ratio of fugacities, the ratio of CO2 to water is about 400. And as I keep raising the temperature, we can see that this ratio now is about 200. So this simulation allows us to get some idea of how fugacity changes as we change temperature. We're, of course, raising the pressure in this closed volume container, so the fugacity of CO2 goes up. We're also raising the saturation pressure of water, so the fugacity of water goes up.